Hello everyone, and thanks for joining me once again in this video. We will have a look at a few utility classes from the OxyProps framework. And when we talk about utility classes, let's be honest, a lot of them add very few value. When you use a class like padding right of 2 or margin top of 3 or text bold, that kind of classes only assigns a value to a single CSS property, and most of the time you will spend more time looking for the class than directly assigning the value. But when a utility class is very useful, it's when it does a lot of work for you. And that's the case for some of the OxyProps utility classes. So let's have a look at it. And this is a fresh new site I just created. We only have Oxygen and OxyProps installed. So let's say we are working on a website, which is a text-heavy website, a documentation website, for example. And we would like to have a header with a menu, of course, a footer, a left menu in a sidebar, and a right sidebar with article suggestion or a table of content, for example. So let's go and create a template. Let's add a new template and name it Holy Grail, because that kind of layout with a header, footer, left and right sidebars and content, main content in the middle, is often referred to as the Holy Grail layout. And this will apply to pages. Publish and edit with Oxygen. I will open my structure panel and I will add a div, and this div will be my page container. It's already full width, but I also want it to be full height, so I will add an exact height of 100 VH. And this div will be my page container. And in my layout, I want a header, a footer, a left sidebar, a right sidebar, and a main content. So that's 5 areas inside my container. So let's add 5 divs. I have the first one and let's duplicate it. Okay, so now we have 5. And this is where utility classes can be handy and do a lot of work for you. And in this case, a lot of work for you using CSS grids. And we will go and look for the class Holy Grail. It's here as a suggested class. And I will apply this class o-holy-grail to my page container. And you see that instantly my 5 divs take their place. We have a header, a footer, a left sidebar, a right sidebar, and a main content. So let's name them. So how this class works is that it created a CSS grid, and it uses 2 properties from the OxyProps framework. The first one defines templates for the rows and columns in the grid, and the second one defines grid areas. We will go and have a look later at exactly how this works with the dev tools. But for now, I can tell you that as our page container is full width and full height, it will use a full screen. Each one of the 4 surrounding divs, the header, footer, and the 2 sidebars, are configured to use the height for the header and footer and the width for the 2 sidebars that will fit whatever content we place inside them. And the central main area will use all the remaining space. So let's start with our main area. For now, we are previewing the sample page, but we have no information because we need to add an inner content, of course. And now we have our content appearing. Still working on my main. I want to give it the proper tag, so I will give it a tag of main, and I will also give it some spacing with a padding of 4, and I want that on all sides. Perfect. Let's go to our header. I will give it a tag of header. I will add my site logo. This will be my brand color. I will add my main navigation. I want it to be horizontal, middle aligned. I want space between my items, and I will add padding at the top and bottom. And that's one of the occasions where a spacing utility class could come handy, because I have to define top and bottom padding. I can, of course, do it here using 2 and 2, but I can also do it using a utility class that will be a pad-bl, because I want a padding block. A padding block is top and bottom for horizontal languages, and I can add a padding block of 2. Let's save. Let's take care of the footer. We'll give it a tag of footer. I want to add my logo. I want it to be subtle. I will add a surface 4, for example. And let's add some copyright text. And let's make it horizontal, middle aligned, space between, and again, a padding block of 2. In my left bar, I want a menu, so I will add a text. Menu with a font size of 1, text color of text 1, a font weight of 200. Let's add a navigation. I did not create several menus in my WordPress dashboard, but of course, we could create a specific left menu and select it from the dropdown. I want it to be vertical, perfect. And I will add a top padding of 4 to my sidebar to match my main content. One last thing, on my left bar, I want to select a tag and this will be an aside. Perfect. And now let's take care of the right bar. This one will also be an aside. And inside this one, I want to use Oxygen table of content, the table of content element. I will also add padding to my left container. And let's say that I want my table of content to be positioned sticky. I could add a sticky class, but as I want fine control on its top position, I will go to the ID and to custom CSS, and I will add a sticky snippet that gives me the position sticky and the top position. By default, it's positioned at size fluid 2, but having it directly in my custom CSS, it will be easy to modify and adjust. Let's apply code, save, and have a look at the front end. And here is our page. So as we are logged in and we have the admin bar, it's not perfect. So we are now in an incognito window, and we can see that this layout uses the full width and full height of our screen. We have our header, our right bar, our left bar with the menu, and our footer. So of course, if we really want it full screen, we want some padding and so on right and left. So let's go and add some padding, and we will add this padding to the page container, and we will add a padding, but this time it will be an inline padding, left and right. And let's add a padding inline 4. Save, back to our front end, refresh, and we have our layout. By default, the Holy Grail utility class forces the layout to be contained in the page, which means that our header and our footer will always be visible. And the central part, the main, has an overflow of scroll Y, meaning that for long content, the central area, the main area, is scrollable and your footer will always be visible, which can be useful if you design a specific nav for your footer. Or if you create an app and you want to use your footer as a status bar, for example. If I want a different behavior and come back to what we are used to on website, I will select my main area, go to Advanced, Layout, and select an overflow of visible. We can see now in the builder that our footer was pushed to the bottom. Let's save and back to the front end, refresh. And now we have the same layout, but the main area uses as much height as it needs. We have our footer at the bottom and our table of content is sticky. Perfect. Now, what if you don't want to use full screen width, but you want to contain the width to fit your Oxygen global setting, maybe to accommodate other pages or other templates on your side? Well, once again, let's go back to the builder, to our page container. Let's remove this padding and go to the size and spacing, and we will assign a max width. And this one, I didn't make it available from the context menu, but I think I will because it can be handy for you. So let's insert a property that will be var double dash o dash, as any var has any custom property in OxyProps, and that will be oxy for oxygen dash page dash width. And this property automatically grabs whatever page width value you did set in your global styles and makes it available for the whole framework. Let's exaggerate so we can really see. And let's say we want 1120, save. And let's go and check our front end. And we want to center it. So let's add a left and right margin of auto, save. And let's have a look at the front end. And this is our result. The same layout with the top header, the left sidebar, the right one, the main area, our footer at the bottom, our table of content is sticky, and this whole layout is defined by this single class, o-holy-grail. I'll come back to the scrollable version by removing this overflow visible on the ID. You see that our footer is back to the front end. I refresh and we have our footer visible and the central area is scrollable. Let's have a look at the dev tools for a minute. I'll bring it to the screen. Here we are. Okay, I will enlarge it a little. And as the structure, we can see our page container here with the proper tags inside it, the header, the aside, the main, the aside, and the footer. Our page container has a display grid, so let's activate it so we can see the grid. And let's have a look at the areas because it's defined with grid template areas. And you can see that this class here did assign a grid template of a variable named o-holy-grail template and a grid template areas of a variable named o-holy-grail template areas. And this define named areas for each part of the grid that you can see here, the head, left, main, right, and footer at the bottom. Let's hide this grid and just take a look at what happens in responsive mode. And in mobile mode, you can see that all five divs stack on top of each other. Of course, I didn't apply any styling to my menus, so by default, they turn to mobile menus. We have our main in the middle, our table of content, maybe you will want to hide it in the mobile version, and the footer. And when we enlarge the viewport, the layout takes place. So first, the table of content expands and takes whatever width is necessary for it. And if we expand again, the left menu expands and the left sidebar uses whatever width is necessary to fit the content. Let's go back to Oxygen. And this was kind of a complex layout with header, footer, left, right, sidebars, and the main content. But we can have a simple one, a more classical one. So let's imagine we want only a header, footer, and our main content. Let's remove the left bar and the right bar. So of course, this breaks the layout as the system expects 5 children divs inside the Holy Grail. But let's remove it and replace it by another class, which is stack. And with this stack class, we get the expected result. We have a header div, a main div, and a footer div. Let's look at it on the front end, header, main area, and footer. And on this one again, if you want your footer to be always visible and only the central area to be scrollable, let's go to advanced layout, set the overflow to scroll, save, check the front end. And we now have our header, our footer, and the central area, the main content area, only being scrollable. So this is the stack layout utility class. And to finish, we may want to have only a left sidebar or a right sidebar in this central area. So let's wrap our main in a div. I will call this one the meat, because why not? That's the meat in the sandwich. I'll add a div to this area. This will be my left. I will give it a tag of a side. And I'll go to my meat. That's the container for the whole central area. And I will give it a class of sidebar. And you see that we have 6 different ones. We have left sidebars, right sidebars, and a number that defines the minimum dimension of the sidebar. So I'll go with sidebar 1, and instantly the system created my sidebar I can give it a background color, of course, and I can add once again maybe a table of content that will be sticky. Add a block padding, and let's have a look at the front end. Of course, our table of content needs styling to be readable. The sidebar expands to the footer, that leaves plenty of room for our sticky table of content to be sticky. And here we still have our page width contained, but I will remove this max width, add back a padding inline. To demonstrate how the class works, let's refresh. And you see that now the sidebar is wider, because the way it works is that it defines a minimum width given by the number on the class. In our case, it was a left sidebar of 1, which has then a minimum width of content 1. But when the viewport expands, it takes 25% of the available width. Let's inspect and have a look at it. That's our div, our central div with the grid. So we have the grid visible here. And this one uses a grid template columns with a min-max function that takes as parameter our minimum width, our normal width, and 1FR, meaning that every available space left, one fraction of the available space left, will be used by our main content. And this brings this video to an end. I hope you enjoyed it. I really encourage you to play and experiment with CSS grids, with the grid template columns, with the grid template rows, with the grid template areas. And of course, if you want to be faster and benefit from done-for-you custom classes, you can have a look at OxyProps. And I'll see you in the next video.